Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and today we are going to discuss how to analyze the ascendant nakshatra and why the ascendant nakshatra is very important and what kind of clues it can give us regarding the things that the person is interested. Okay. And when we see ascendant nakshatra, we will not only analyze the nakshatra in the ascendant, but we will also analyze the nakshatra of the ascendant lord. So for example, in this chart, as you see, it is Cancer rising and it is Paschami, which means Pushya nakshatra is rising in the ascendant, and ascendant lord is moon, because moon rules Cancer. He is lord of the first house and he is himself situated in Ashwini nakshatra. Okay, so the most important nakshatras here are Pushya and Ashwini in context of this video. So we will discuss how to see these nakshatras and how to understand the power of these nakshatras. Okay, and how these two nakshatras will push the chart in a particular direction, which would be very surprising for some people, because sometimes you will see the same horoscope with one or two planets different, but then you are wondering what is that which is there in the horoscope, because of which the lives of these two persons are totally different. That is the ascendant nakshatra and the nakshatra of the ascendant lord, right? So we will discuss in short. As usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation from me, you can go to the description section down below of my videos to find the link to my website. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what is going on in this chart? And the birth details are as follows: 14th April 1983. You can also make the chart in your software and check accordingly. Time is 12:05 in the afternoon. And place is Haldia, West Bengal, India. And this is the North Indian chart. Unfortunately, I cannot show the South Indian style here, but I will try my best to include South Indian charts in the future also. Okay, so at a first glance, if you ignore the ascendant nakshatra and the ascendant lord's nakshatra, which is Ashwini and Pushya, then what do you feel? Oh, this chart is very much focused towards career, you know, name, fame, position, power, authority, because the Lagna Lord is in 10th house, Mars is forming Mahapurush Yoga, Ruchak Mahapurush Yoga. Yes, because Mars is in Kendra, in own sign, in Mool Trikon. Then Sun is in the 10th house, it's in Digbala, Mars also in Digbala. Then Mercury in the 10th, Moon in the 10th, Venus in the 11th, fantastic chart, Jupiter in the 5th, can't get better than this. So it appears as if this person is very much interested towards getting name, fame, power, position, status and authority. It seems as if it is like this. But what if I told you this person is not at all interested in all this? Not at all. In fact, you go and tell the person that, oh my dear sir, actually, you know, if you do this, you will become famous. You know, you will get more money, you will get more fame, you will be known in the entire world. Why don't you do that? And then this person is like, ah, I'm least interested in all this. Don't waste my time. Why did you ever ask this question? Well, the secret lies in the ascendant nakshatra and the nakshatra of the Lord of the Ascendant. If you carefully see in this chart, according to sign, which is the most powerful planet here in this chart, sign wise, yes, you are right. It is exalted Saturn. It is Saturn because it is exalted in Libra. And Mars is in Mool Trikon, and Sun and Mars are in Digbala, and Venus is in own sign. And Rahu is also exalted, Ketu is also exalted, but because Saturn is in Kendra, he is much more strong. So this one placement is almost driving the chart. But what is so special about Saturn? Many people have exalted Saturn. But if you see carefully, the ascendant nakshatra is Pushya. And Pushya nakshatra is the nakshatra of service, serving others. But then many people have Pushya. Why don't they serve? If you look carefully, who is the nakshatra lord of Pushya? Yes, it is Saturn. So now you see where this Saturn is placed. Saturn is in the fourth house. Fourth house is Patal because it is directly opposite of the house of fame. See, 10th house is where the sun is during the peak, when you can literally feel the heat of the sun. You know, you are sweating, and if it's winter, you are really enjoying that time. But imagine during the night what happens. Sun is in the fourth house. So this is exactly opposite of Digbala. That's called as Dikshunya. Okay. So this is one of the major reasons why this person does not like fame. In fact, this person runs away from fame. Now that there is the predicament, you see, because there are so many planets in the 10th house and the 11th lord is also in own sign, own house. So this person is destined to get some level of fame. Lagna lord, 10th lord conjunct in the 10th house. Now, moon Mars forming Shashi Mangala Yoga, great placement. But because this nakshatra lord of the ascendant Saturn is placed in the fourth house, this person is not interested. And now if you see moon, where is moon? Moon is in Ashwini nakshatra. Ashwini is lorded by Ketu, and where is Ketu sitting? Ketu is sitting in the sixth house in Sagittarius. It is also exalted. Make sure you note these two planets, Saturn and Ketu, both are exalted. They are very strong, equally strong indeed, and Rahu also. So what is sixth house? Sixth house is the house of service. Sixth house is the house of offering any kind of help to people. Okay. So this Ketu plays a very crucial role in helping people, because he is placed in the 6th house, and Ketu is placed in Mula Nakshatra. If you see, Mula Nakshatra is also related to Ayurveda and trying to help people using medicines, or trying to go to the root of problems and then trying to solve the problems. So that is what Mula Nakshatra is all about, going to the root and hit it where you need to and when you need to. That's Mula Nakshatra. But this is not enough. You also have to check different things. So for example, if you check the nakshatras of this Saturn and Ketu, you will get more clues of what kind of healing the person would like. So Saturn, you see, is in Swati nakshatra. It is exalted. And Ketu, as I said, is in Mula. So Mula can at times show Ayurveda. And Swati can at times show meditation, yoga and pranayama, because it is related to Vayu, and there are five kinds of airs in the human body, you know, pran, apan, vayan, saman, udan. So Swati nakshatra is very closely associated and linked to these postures of yoga and yogic methodologies. Hatha yoga basically. And Mula Nakshatra is also related to roots, Ayurveda, and at times I have seen if moon is linked, homeopathy also is seen by Mula Nakshatra. Okay. So this person is a yoga teacher from last decade. And this person is, his life, his motto in life is, he's not interested in money at all. He is only interested in serving others. He is only interested in helping others. His attitude is, whatever comes of its own accord, I will accept, but I am not going to run behind money, or I am not going to chase money, basically. I just want to serve people. And he is very much interested in healing. Why healing? Which is the house of healing? Yes, you guessed it right. It is the fourth house. What happens when you come home? You feel as if you have started healing. You start resting. Yes. When do you rest? Yes, yes, yes. It is the 12th house. So 12th house also has this exalted Rahu there. And then you have, see, Ketu is in the 6th house. Okay. So Ketu wants to do good to people by healing, which is the 12th house and also the 4th house. So the 12th house and the 4th house are extremely well placed in this chart, and this is what makes all the difference. And if you see the 12th lord also, it is in the 10th, and the 11th lord, the 4th lord is also in the 11th, which is also the 11th lord, by the way. So these are fantastic placements to have, actually. So apart from this, if you see, the nakshatras are going to give you a very interesting story. You see, he has three planets in Ashwini nakshatra. Okay, he has sun in 0 degree, and then moon, and he has Mars also in Ashwini, and Mercury is in Bharani nakshatra. This is a very interesting placement, Mercury in Bharani. So now if you check, whenever it comes to yoga and other stuff, anything which is traditional or related to the scriptures, especially Ayurveda or Hatha yoga, or could be meditation also, you must check the trines. Without the strength of the trines, the person cannot get the blessings of the God and the gurus. Why? Because the trines are known as Lakshmi Sthan. Goddess Lakshmi personally blesses you with good things in life from your past. Because of your good deeds of the past, you get the blessings of Goddess Lakshmi. And nowadays, when I say that Goddess Lakshmi is blessing, people interpret it in mundane terms like cash or a good wife or a good husband or good children, all the materialistic commodities. But it is not like that. Goddess Lakshmi's blessings can come in many ways. So although the trines are known as Lakshmi Sthan, but you will hardly see that the trines give you money. The money houses are not in any way linked to the trines. The houses of money are 2nd, 6th, 10th and 11th. But the houses of the Lakshmi Sthanas are 5th and the 9th. So therefore, we should never mistake we should not fool ourselves and others by thinking that Lakshmi is only money, or it is only, you know, prosperity on a mundane sense. So now you check, where are the trinal lords situated? First, the first trinal lord is Mars, because this is the 5th house. Mars, Scorpio, is ruled by Mars and Ketu. So Mars is sitting in the 10th house there. You see, it is in Digbara and it is extremely powerful. So the blessings of Goddess Lakshmi is coming to his career. 5th and 10th linked, best placements to have in the chart. Then where is Ketu? The other lord is Ketu. Ketu is situated in the 6th house, in the house of service. It is exalted there. So again, a fantastic placement to have. So one lord is exalted. The other lord is in the 10th in Digbala, forming Ruchaka Mahapurush Yoga. You know, aspected by this Shani, which is the Nakshatra Lord of the Ascendant Nakshatra. And don't forget, this Ketu is also the Ascendant Lord of the Nakshatra where the Ascendant Lord is sitting. Okay, I mean the Nakshatra Lord of Venus, which is Moon, which is Ashwini. Okay, Ashwini is ruled by Ketu. So therefore, this makes the chart 10 times more powerful. And now the ninth Lord. The ninth Lord shows the blessings of the Guru. So where are the Guru, blessings of the Guru going? There you see, ninth Lord is in the fifth. Another fantastic placement. Again, Jupiter is in a great sign for Jupiter. Scorpio is a difficult sign, but for Jupiter, it's a great sign. And it is in Jyeshtha Nakshatra. It is retrograde also, point to be noted. Okay. So, whenever the ninth Lord is retrograde or aspected by a retrograde planet, it could happen that you follow a particular parampara and sometimes you might leave that parampara. Okay, these are the things which might appear sometimes, I have seen. And this is something which had happened with this person. This person had chosen a particular line of yoga, but then this person was not able to identify quite a bit with that level, with that school of yoga, and then later on this person changed to another school of yoga, and now this person is very successful in that domain. So, and the most important thing that this person stresses is on breathing, because this Saturn is in Swati Nakshatra. And Saturn is anyway related to the bones also, Sun and Saturn, both of them. And in yoga, you know, the bones have to be calculatively, they have to be moved in a way by which the five kinds of airs are balanced in the body. That is all Ashtanga Yoga is ultimately, okay. So now, this person is a Brahmachari, he is a celibate, he is not married. He never got married and he is not willing to get married also. Now, you may say, oh my God, 7th Lord is exalted here. Saturn is the 7th Lord, he is exalted. No. And then Venus, the natural Karaka for marriage and relationships, he is in own sign, in the 11th house of networks. Well, this person has a lot of lady disciples. Female students, but that's obvious because Venus is in the 11th, so that shows connections with the opposite sex in that area, which is, you know, network circles. But this is not a personal relationship that he has. These are more clients or, you know, more of his students who respect him very much. And also, if you see the Navamsha chart, his Lagna Lord Venus is in the 6th house of celibacy, you see. And it is exalted then. That means he is very happy following celibacy. He is not at all interested in marriage or getting married or forming any kind of relation with women. Alright, so if you see here, you know, the 7th Lord is exalted here. And this 7th Lord is that same Saturn which is giving this yoga and pranayam. Okay. So, there we came to know how this Pushya Nakshatra from with which we started is functioning through Saturn in Swati, and this Moon in Ashwini is functioning through Ketu in Mula. So, these are very interesting nakshatras to observe, and therefore, sometimes if you feel that your astrology study is not becoming complete, then you need to study these two nakshatras. And in fact, these two nakshatras are very important. In fact, sometimes I give them more weightage than the Moon nakshatra also. But for Cancer ascendant, the Moon, the nakshatra Lord of Moon becomes very important because Moon is also the Lagna Lord. Okay. But for the rest of the ascendants, I give equal weightage to the Moon nakshatra, ascendant nakshatra, and the nakshatra of the ascendant Lord. Okay. So in this case, it is Pushya and Ashwini, and the story is being narrated by Saturn and Ketu. And that is it from my side. So next time, please give importance to these two nakshatras and see where the nakshatra lords are sitting, which nakshatras they are occupying. That will give you the ultimate clue of what a person will be doing in this life, okay? And by that you can actually help the person and just not make some useless predictions after 5 years or 3 years or after 100 years, okay? And also check the Navamsa chart, check the strength of the planets there, okay? Thank you very much. Wish you all the best and bye-bye.